everybody. Glad you've made the decision to be with us. Alongside Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore, and we're glad to be bringing you action and welcoming you to the famed New York Arena here in Midtown Manhattan for a much-anticipated main event. Scheduled for 15 rounds of heavyweight action. This should be a good one tonight. Both fighters say they are primed, coming off a very intense and passionate training camp. His focus is front and center as he makes his way to the ring right now. George Foreman's coming down to the ring now, and what a nice reception as he is completely focused in on his goal tonight.
Okay, guys, we went over the rules in the dressing room. Let's touch gloves.
When you get a fight like this that everybody's been talking about, it's always so interesting to see these opening moments here in round number one. Teddy, we've seen both these guys before, and we have a feeling, you just kind of have the feeling that it could be one of those special nights.
Yeah, because their styles, it suits up for one of those special nights.
Fighting fire with fire sometimes can work, but can it work under circumstances like this when a power puncher is going up against George Foreman?
Yeah, it can. In other words, you have to have a little defense to go with that ability to generate fire, or in this case, power.
Rocked by a huge hook to the head. Very nice work to the head. The right hand landed. Fires off the hook. Look at that. Accurate shot. Straight right hand comes in. Tucks those elbows in. Blocks the body shot. And he just holds on there. A headshot blocked. Halfway through round number one. A little 1-2, jab followed by the cross. Teddy, why is it in boxing that there are so many distinct styles that are defined by geography or culture or ethnicity, where we have a Mexican-styled fighter, an Eastern European, you know, upright fighter, an American-styled fighter? Why is that?
Because you are influenced by your surroundings, by the temperament of the people in your surroundings.
Hey, you got
aggressive people, aggressive style. Very thoughtful people, people that are very cerebral. Well, you're going to have a defensive style. You're going to have a very careful style. It's going to fit right in.
So he decides to go downstairs early on, and I think he'll be happy with that decision later on.
Well, it tells you that he's a well-prepared fighter. His corner came in here with a good game plan. They understood what they had in front of him. A guy that's going to move a little bit. Start going downstairs, taking the air out of the tires, and later on, he'll be in front of you.
10 seconds to go in this round.
Yeah, good work.
And we come to the end of round number one. You know, Teddy, I'm looking at that cut as he's in the corner now, and it doesn't look good at all. Do you think he thinks he has to go out there and try to end this fight?
Not only does he think it, I think he's right. I think that he probably has very little time left before the referee or the doctor is going to stop this. And he needs to be thinking that way if he's not.
The body.
Hey, relax. Relax. You're doing great. Keep the pressure off.
Here we go. Round two is underway. And now he scores well with a straight right. Headhunting never hurt, does it with the hook. Look at this, another power punch able to land. We're early on in this fight, he's going for it.
Yeah, you wonder if he's got a call waiting outside.
Now hugging on the inside. Just hugging there. Flush shot, the left hand came in. Big uppercut right on the mark. Missed the body shot. Just an excessive amount of holding here. Just much too much clinching. Reaching the halfway mark of this round. Oh, you see him with the left of the head there? George Foreman's way off the mark. That punch didn't have a chance. Is damaged badly there. He may hit the floor.
Finish with a hook.
There's that overhand right. Scored well with the hook. Nice work with the uppercut. George Foreman, originally from Marshall, Texas, where as a youth, Teddy, he was involved in a lot of street fights, and he had a reputation as the kind of guy that you didn't mess with out and about.
You know, we've had a lot of fighters that have come out that route. Boxing has saved, has turned a lot of young men who were in trouble on the streets, turned them into not only world champions, but, you know, world champions as people, people that could serve society. Foreman is one of those young men.
Just 10 seconds to go here in the second round. Gets rid of that body shot. George Foreman's hurt by a superb hook to the head. And that's the end of round two. George Foreman cutting that last round.
You know, George Foreman is a guy, a lot of people have called him a bully, you know, and a lot of times you want to find out how a bully's going to behave the first time he gets a bloody nose. Let's find out right now how George is going to behave now that he's got a cut over his eye.
Let's go. The fight is too close. You hear me? It's too fucking close. We don't want this to go to the judges' scorecards, right?
George Foreman's corner did a good job in that last round. They really got their fighter back to where he needs to be after being damaged in that last round.
And that's not the only good job they did in the corner. They did a good job in the camp because obviously they have him in top shape and it's paying dividends right now.
Not hitting his mark there going upstairs. There's the headshot, but he parries it away. A well-placed left hand up top. Very good work on the inside with the uppercut. Now, if you're standing opposite that right there, Teddy, what do you have to do to stop it?
Well, first of all, you have to understand and recognize that's the punch you should be aware of and close, because there's only a few punches. You're in real close. There's not room for too many other punches. The uppercut is the one you expect. So expect it, first of all, and move your head on the side so it misses you.
Targeting a left hand down low. Now he missed that right. What a big shot from George Foreman.
Unload!
George Foreman's feeling the effects now of that hook. Coming to the halfway point of this third round. Gets him with the right hand. And now he's targeting upstairs. Not able to connect with the uppercut. Teddy, you get your hands on George Foreman. You can shape him any way you want. What do you want to improve with him?
Well, first of all, you want to understand what you don't want to mess with. I think that's the most important thing to a good teacher, a good trainer. What not to touch. Obviously, his confidence that he can hurt you, and his ability to control distance, to be set on his feet. He knows he's a puncher, and he's always set to punch. That's one good thing about him. You want to improve his technique. He leaves holes. Shorten his punches up a little bit. Cover. A lot of times after he throws a heavy punch, that heavy punch drops down and he leaves himself open. He doesn't cover back the way you would want to. The old timers would say, throw a punch, test hot water. Get that hand right back.
Still not moving enough. Move, move.
Good defense, just covering up down low. Final 10 seconds.
Get him, get him.
Able to block that away. It was targeted for his head.
Nice work, nice work. Don't get too close. Don't get too close, all right? I need you to move more.
Listen. You need to move your head more, side to side, okay? I want to see that head move more.
You gotta watch the water in the corner too much.
We open up round number four here. Let's look at Teddy's scorecard, where he's up 2-1. I like his work rate, Teddy.
You know, he's not landing all the time clean, but it reminds me a little bit of some of the old fans used to say to me, Teddy, Marciano, we love Marciano, you know, the Rock. He used to hit guys on his arms. He wasn't hitting them clean, but he was breaking their blood vessels. Excuse me for being so graphic, but he was breaking their blood vessels, and they couldn't keep their arms up by the time they got to the 8th, 9th, 10th round. That's kind of the way this guy fights.
He's tight. He's tight.
He comes with a straight right hand. Good left there. Good effective work with that straight right hand. Right to the belt line. Big shot he just scored with. Down on the floor from a hook.
One, two, three, four, five.
Foreman's corner needs to really get to their man after this round. They need to treat him after that knockdown. They also need to give him some sound advice. What's the advice you'd give him?
Well, first of all, if they're going to get the chance to get to him, he better move his head. But the advice I would give him is, hey, you go out this next round and you kill some time. Tie him up a little bit right from the beginning. Don't worry about losing the early part of the fight or the early part of the round. Just get yourself back together.
Halfway through round number four. He is wobbly and damaged and just flailing with his arms trying to punch back.
Let it go!
Foreman's inability to hit the target is really making him look silly right now. He's throwing plenty of punches, just none of them are landing.
No, he's throwing them too wide, too far away. And what's going to be worse, right now he's only getting frustrated, maybe embarrassed, as you touched on. But what's going to be worse is when he starts getting countered in between them.
And that's what fighters do. Pulls the trigger right away after taking one. Now he ties up there. Keeps his hands up defensively, protecting the head. Fourth round now with its last 10 seconds. Blocks away that headshot. Round comes to an end. We saw the knockdown there in that round. A little bit of a momentum gainer.
Yeah, obviously it gives you confidence, but you know what? It can also be a momentum killer, believe it or not.
How so?
Joe, I've had guys where the worst thing that happened to them in a fight was when they scored the knockdown because they thought it was just going to keep happening. And they thought about only the punch they landed, not how they set it up. So they got away from the game plan.
Okay, breathe in. Take a deep breath.
Foreman's got to be so careful here, Teddy. He was knocked down in the last round, and you know his opponent's going to be gunning for him here at the start of this round.
But this is where you walk a tightrope, so to speak, because if he's too careful, as you alluded to, then guess what? His opponent walks in, and the fight's going to get stopped. So, yeah, he's got to be smart, but he's also got to pitch something at his opponent, chuck something at his opponent to keep him off a little bit, too.
Blocks that belt line well. Scores well to the head with the right hand.
Get in there.
His opponent wanted the body. He wouldn't give it to him. Really frustrating his opponent now as he's so defensively sound. It doesn't make for an easy target.
No, it doesn't. And it makes for a very frustrating night for his opponent. I see his opponent now. If you notice, he's getting a little tentative. He's afraid to let the punches go because when he misses, he's worried he's going to leave an opening.
Comes right back at him with a left hand. George Foreman's hit by a counterpunch there. Halfway into round number five here.
You're doing great.
Go.
Good looking counterpunch. He needs to improve the accuracy a little bit. That was comical by George Foreman.
Work the body.
Pulls the trigger right away with the left hand after getting tagged himself.
Keep working the body.
That's what I want to see.
Nice block by Foreman. Foreman's just being very hesitant right now offensively. His first thought since being stunned in this fight is protect myself, protect myself. It's like he's turned the off switch on his offense.
Yeah, but you can't do that. The lights go off, it gets all dark there. You have to find a way to still have that light on. You know, find the window of opportunity somewhere. They are out there. Be creative.
He took a shot, but he gives one of his own. A left hand scores. this round comes to an end. And you can just see that he doesn't have much to him, not much energy there. I mean, how does a trainer fix that?
Well, first of all, you said a key word there. You said you can just see. Well, his opponent can see it, so he's not going to slow down. His opponent now is going to come out even faster. So if you're the trainer, the first thing you say is, hey, take a deep breath, get yourself together. Don't let this guy know you're tired. You're not tired.
It's going to happen. You're going to catch it. You're going to catch it. Listen to me. You're not giving me enough punches, okay? Throw more punches.
The start of the sixth round.
Back to the body.
George Foreman stunned, and he is hurt.
Now, finish him off.
Teddy, there are opportunities that are here for him, aren't there?
Yeah, counterpunch opportunities, because he's got an opponent who's walking in a little bit. Now he has a chance to start to chuck something back at him a little.
He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. Tried to land that upstairs and was off the mark. Return to sender. He gives him back one of his own. Halfway through round six. Very accurate with the overhand right. That punch intended for the head. Here's something that's a key factor now, and that is his ability to simply defend himself. He's doing a wonderful job at it.
Yeah, he is, and that gives him the ability to always be fresh and confident round after round, since he's not taking a lot of punishment.
Foreman's in a bad place right now. He was tagged. As that round comes to an end, it gives us a moment to kind of reflect on this overall fight. And Teddy, my thoughts are pretty clear cut. This is the kind of fight that just takes on a personality of its own. This is an all-out war.
Yeah, this is kind of like watching a guy who's not on a budget. You know, he's spending with both hands. You know, when he goes home, he's going to have no money in his pockets. And when this fight is over, these guys are going to have nothing left in the gas tank, and it's probably not going to a decision.
He's got nothing left.
Here we go. Action to start the seventh round. Foreman's looking all right here as we start this round, but it was just a round ago that he got tagged. He was stunned there in that last round. What do you expect from him here, Teddy?
Well, I think he's starting to gain a little bit of confidence because, you know, now he's been left alone a little bit. And that, see, that's the danger. His opponent is letting him get himself healthy again. And if a guy who's been hurt starts to gain confidence, all of a sudden, you have a tougher fight than you ever thought you were going to have on your hands.
Unload!
Nice nowhere work. Nice close work. That punch by George Foreman. George Foreman's almost looking foolish that time he missed so badly. Teddy, I'm starting to wonder, what is the answer for this guy? Can he do anything else than this? Yeah, he throws punches, but he has no accuracy. Can this change in mid-fight?
Well, it has to if he wants to win this fight. And how does it change? Well, you know, the problem is these things have to be put in place in the gym. I don't know if you could do it right now, but if you could, you tell him in the corner, hey, tighten up a little bit, you know, shorten up these darn punches.
Foreman's showing that he's got some defense of his own. He got away from that punch.
Side to side, move your head.
See him holding on.
Looking good.
Ten clicks of the talk.
Shit, you are in control of this fight, man. Don't get careless out there, right? Just keep boxing smart.
Nice work. Keep it up.
Listen, I need to see more counter punches, okay? Whenever he misses, counter.
As we start round number eight, chance to look at Teddy's scorecard, and nothing has really changed. He's been in complete control the whole night, almost getting his opponent into that desperate place, but I don't think he has the answers.
Well, somebody needs to tell him. I'll tell you the answer. Somebody needs to tell him that it's not against the law.
Oh, that's good stuff. Fire it right back with one of his own. Good words, Foreman. Oh, he is stunned. Solid. George Foreman. Can he move on?
Two, three, four, five, six, eight, nine, ten.
That's it. It's over. Fight is over. Foreman's night has ended early here. Couldn't rise up and beat the count. That's what you want to see, a guy who can close the show and finish with style. He ends up a knockout victor tonight.
And that's what his trainer wanted. His trainer was even telling him, step it up a little bit, because he knew this was possible, and they got it.
For Teddy Atlas, I'm Joe Tessitore. Have yourself a great night.